I go. For I want you to know that I'm looking for romance.
I bring you a song in the hope that you see when you're looking at me that I'm looking for love.
Actor Sterling Holloway, who had provided the voice for the Cheshire Cat in Alice in Wonderland, was cast as Winnie the Pooh.
To be in the same recording studio with Sterling Holloway was a great treat. I mean, the man was a consummate artist. I used to watch the way he performed. He used to underplay his lines. He would do them so softly and so easily.
Oh, hello. Am I glad to see you? It's more friendly with two.
Sterling Holloway was just, well, I was going to say he was a teddy bear. He was. He was like Pooh. He was the human version of Pooh.
I recognize you. You're the bear in my father's drawings.
Winnie the Pooh, are we going to be friends?
Pooh's voice is like a breeze whispering through the cattails. You know, it's the sound of leaves, skittering across the sidewalk.
It's just instantly recognizable.
Who's that?
That was created more recently by Jim Cummings.
It's been so long since we've been doing it, since 87 myself, so it's almost half my life.
I won't ever forget about you, Pooh. Not even when I'm 100.
I'm just honored.
He knows Pooh better than anyone, and he delivers it. You just hear his voice, and he's Pooh.
She can't be Pooh. I'm Pooh.
There's a nostalgia that just hits you right away and a warmth.
People have asked me, what is it about that voice? Well, you know, it's not mine, to be fair. I borrowed it from the late, great Sterling Holloway. When Walt Disney was gearing up to do Winnie the Pooh, it's my understanding that he really just thought of Sterling Holloway because he was very familiar with him. The stork in Dumbo.
Ooh, at last.
Ka in Jungle Book.
So nice to see you again.
Interestingly enough, that was just his speaking voice.
I just really love doing Winnie the Pooh.
It is exciting.
It's right between my falsetto and my upper register of my regular voice. And then you just sort of filter in a little bit of sand and then some whimsy. Oh, there you have it. And once you incorporate that into the beautiful simplicity and, gosh, serenity that is Winnie the Pooh, I think it grabs people.
I almost met Sterling Holloway once, many, many moons ago. He lived in Laguna Beach, California. And I was down there, God, way before I was in the business. And I thought I was the only myself and my girlfriend, we were there, and I thought we were the only people in the audience, in the diner, and it was in the hotel lobby, or diner, I think, at the time, and the waitress see her walk over to the corner booth and couldn't see who was there, and she said, well, have you decided finally what you want now? And I hear, yes, I believe I will have the chowder. And I went, you know, because it's very distinct, you know, and I kind of got up and I grabbed some salt off the table. And, oh, it's Winnie the Pooh. You know, it was Sterling Holloway, and I, you know, what do you do? You go up and go, hi. Okay, that's it. I don't have anything else, you know. So I didn't say anything. Of course, I regret it now. I wish I did.
And so we come to the last chapter, in which Christopher Robin and Pooh come to the enchanted place. And we say goodbye.
Goodbye? Oh, no, please, can't we go back to page one and do it all over again?
Sorry, Pooh, but all stories have an ending, you know.
Oh, bother.
Pooh? Huh? What do you like doing best in the world?
What I like best is me going to visit you and you saying, how about a smackerel of honey?
I like that too. But what I like best is just doing nothing.
How do you do just nothing?
Well, it's when grown-ups ask, what are you going to do? And you say nothing. And then you go out and do it.
I like that. Let's do it all the time.
You know something, Pooh? I'm not going to do just nothing anymore.
You mean never again?
Well, not so much. Pooh, when I'm away just doing nothing, will you come up here sometimes?
You mean alone? Just me?
Yes. And Pooh, promise you won't forget me? Ever?
Oh, I won't, Christopher. I promise.
Not even when I'm 100?
How old shall I be then?
99. Silly old bear.
Wherever they go, and whatever happens to them on the way, in that enchanted place on top of the forest, a little bear will always be waiting.
That's what you are. Unforgettable, though near or far. Like a song of love that clings to me, how the thought of you does things to me. Never before has someone been more unforgettable in every way. And forevermore, that's how you'll stay. That's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable too. How you'll stay. That's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable too.